and welcome back to Perfect Smiles with Dr. Sarah. In today's episode, I'm going to be asking members of the public questions that they want to pose towards me all about teeth. I'm filming from the Christmas market here at Southbank in London. So let's go ahead and start asking some members of the public any questions they have about teeth, and I'm going to answer them all for them. Okay, so first question. Hi there.
Hi, how are you?
Good, how are you?
I'm very good, thanks. I was just wondering, is it worth actually using electric toothbrush rather than a manual one? I've always wondered.
That is a brilliant question. Is it worth using an electric toothbrush rather than a manual one? So electric toothbrushes have been investigated in many studies, and research does show that they reduce plaque and gingivitis if used over a 3-month period. I use an electric toothbrush. Actually, I do alternate between using an electric toothbrush and a manual toothbrush. So I'll use an electric toothbrush in the morning and I'll use a manual toothbrush at night. And I just find for me that works really well. But I do recommend using an electric toothbrush to all my patients. I think they're brilliant. They're just fantastic.
Hi, how are you?
Next question. Hi, I'm good, thanks. How are you?
I'm fine, thank you. What do you think of different ways of flossing your teeth? So what do you think of water flosses? Are those any good?
Fantastic. Thank you very much for that. Okay, so what do I think of water flosses? So I have a water floss myself and I do love it. However, I also floss with regular floss, and studies have been carried out on water flosses, and they have shown that they do reduce plaque and gingivitis and bleeding. So they certainly do work. Whether or not you prefer to use them over conventional floss is entirely up to you. Some people find them much easier to use than conventional floss. So I mean, so long as you're cleaning in between your teeth in some way, whether it's floss, water picks, interdental brushes, you know, you have to be cleaning those contacts between your teeth, because it's not enough to just brush your teeth normally. Food does get trapped between teeth, so it's so important to brush in between. Whatever method you're using, just keep going, and if you're not using a method, you know, try and maybe speak to your dentist, find out what method they would recommend for you. Okay, so we've got another person here that's going to be asking us some questions.
Okay.
Go for it.
Italia.
Yeah.
Napoli.
And you're from Italy, Napoli?
Fantastic. Napoli, sì.
Napoli, beautiful. And what's your question about teeth?
The question?
Yeah.
Io. Perché? Perché sono sensibili? Perché io quando bevo cose fredde ho fastidio ai denti.
Okay, so Selena was asking us, why do you get sensitive teeth? Brilliant, thanks.
Cool.
Okay, so question from Selena about why teeth are sensitive. So tooth sensitivity is a very common complaint that I will receive in practice, and most dentists will receive in practice. And I think it's something that needs to be discussed in a lot more detail. However, I'm going to discuss it briefly to answer her question. So tooth sensitivity is caused by exposed enamel and exposed roots of teeth. There can be a number of contributing factors that also lead to sensitivity. So for example, if someone's brushing their teeth too hard, then that causes gingival recession, so the gums can recede on your teeth, and that leads to dentine becoming exposed, which is very sensitive. It can also be caused by cavities, by tooth fractures. So if your tooth is fractured, that can also cause a bit of sensitivity, and it can also be caused by tooth decay, and it can be caused by fillings that are fractured or need replacing. So there are a whole range of causes that can lead to tooth sensitivity. It can be treated, so if you do suffer from tooth sensitivity, be sure to pop in to see your dentist to discuss what the cause is and what would be best to treat your sensitivity. Hi, so what's your name?
Jess.
Hi Jess, so what's your question?
Is whitening bad for your teeth?
Okay, good question, really good question. I'll answer in just a second. What's your name?
Natasha.
Natasha, and what's your question, Natasha?
Wait.
How many?
Wait. What's the best way to like strain your teeth?
Excellent question. What's the best way to straighten your teeth? Now that's a brilliant question because I'm an orthodontist, so that's exactly what I do. Okay, so about the tooth whitening question, is tooth whitening bad for your teeth? So basically, I don't know how old you are, but in the UK, to whiten teeth legally, you need to be 18 years old. Studies have shown that, although there are no real long-term studies on tooth whitening, what it does show is that it can cause sensitivity, but used in the correct way, so whatever way your dentist recommends, using the mouth shield that you use to apply the gel in, it actually doesn't cause any significant damage other than sensitivity. However, there are no really long-term studies on it, so to give you an exact answer is difficult. And your question about whether what are the best ways to straighten teeth?
Yeah.
So there are loads of different ways to straighten teeth, and it entirely depends on your case. So how bad your teeth are, what you prefer, like if you want something that shows, if you want something that doesn't show. So you can get braces around the outside, you can get clear braces, you can get metal braces, you can even get braces around the inside. So it entirely depends on what you prefer and what works for you.
Perfect.
Thanks a lot, girls. Thanks. See you. Bye.
Have a lovely day.
Yeah, have a good day. Bye. What's your name?
Paul.
Thanks, Paul. So what's your question for us?
Well, I was just wondering, you got such lovely white teeth. I just wonder what toothpaste you use, or have you got the magic wand or what?
Thanks. Thank you. Thanks so much. So I tend to alternate between using a whole range of toothpaste brands. Most commonly I will use Oral-B, Colgate, Sensodyne and Corsodil. I don't like to stick to one toothpaste, so I'll just use a whole range really. And so long as your toothpaste has fluoride in, then it's going to be doing the job. What I don't recommend to anyone is using a toothpaste without fluoride, because the fluoride really helps keep your teeth super clean, keeps the bacteria at bay and prevents tooth decay, which is what toothpaste is all about. I also make sure that I professionally clean my teeth, so I go to get my teeth cleaned. I go to get my teeth cleaned, I'd say, you know, once or twice a year at least, and I also whiten my teeth, so I get that done once to twice a year as well. Okay, so I'm here today with Henry Hobhouse, and he has some amazing pickles, curds, jams and chutneys. I'm going to ask him what his question is for me today. Anything about dental health that you've got that you might want to have answered?
That's where I don't even start. I got kicked in the face by a horse.
Really? Oh, wow.
So I don't have teeth.
Okay.
I do, but they're artificial.
What do you do about artificial teeth, sauce?
Not a lot.
Do you use like adhesive to keep them in, or do you go back to get them relined or anything?
Since I was 19.
No.
Maybe like a
checkup
today.
No, thank you.
Okay, so there we go.
Thanks.
So maybe I have been here before. I know the truth. I've walked this floor. Think you are used to it alone. Before I knew ya. Seen your flag on the marble arch. Love is not a victory march. It's a cold. It's a broken heart.